We continue our study with part 3 of chapter 3, which is balance load. In previous part, we learned about three phase system, which is star connection and delta connection. Now, we try to apply the labeling of the star delta connection to find the phase voltage, phase current, line voltage and line current based on the load given. So, first we start with star or Y connection. Okay. To do this, you have to know the voltage across the load. Okay. You cannot use the line voltage. You have to use the phase voltage, which is the voltage across the load. So, the first thing you have to do is to find the phase voltage. Okay. If they don't give the phase voltage, you have to find it using the standard voltage formula. You remember that the V line equals to square root of 3 V phase theta 30. So means that if they give in the line is, for example, 400, okay, 400 theta 0, then the V phase for the phase R means that you have to divide by square root 3, okay, and the angle needs to be negative 30 degree. Okay, because you have to convert from line to phase. If phase to line, you have to add 30 degree. But for line to phase, you have to minus 30 degree. Okay, remember this one? Okay, star connection. Okay, this one. Okay, this one is to get the line voltage. Square root 3 Vp theta angle theta A plus 30 degree. But if they give this delta, the line voltage, you have to divide by square root 3. Okay, the line needs to be divided by square root 3 and the angle needs to be minus 30 degree. Okay, after you get the phase, okay, line voltage, okay, then you have to calculate the line, the phase voltage, you have to calculate the phase current or the line current, which is the same thing. So just use the Ohm's law, okay. IR equals to VRN divided by Z1. IY, VRYN divided by Z2. IB is equal to VBN divided by Z3. Make sure that you use calculator in complex mode because this value will be in complex mode and this value will be in complex. So if VRN is 0, so this one divided by the impedance, which is can be negative value. Okay, make sure that the value here already converted into the frequency domain. Okay, if they give in inductance Henry or capacitor Farad, make sure you convert it to ohm. Okay, try to remember in chapter 2. For this one, you have to use negative 120 if they give it. But if they don't give it, maybe the value will be different. Okay, then calculate for this one and the last phase. Okay, to check whether your answer is correct or not, make sure that the phase for balanced load only, the phase between this and this are 120 degree apart. Okay, if it is not 120 degree apart, your answer can be wrong. Okay, same with four wire. Okay, the calculation is the same. Okay, because this is balanced load, I neutral always 0. Okay, for 4 wire or 3 wire, of course, there is no wire. But 4 wire, when the balanced load is used, and the neutral wire will be 0. Okay, for unbalanced load, you don't have to worry because in your class, there will be no unbalanced load. Okay. The same goes here. Now we move on to delta connection. Okay, as mentioned before, you need to know the phase voltage to calculate the current. Okay, for delta, okay, you have to find the phase current. The problem is that you have to find the phase voltage if you given a line voltage. we have to convert line voltage to phase voltage. For the current, has no problem because the current, phase current and line current will be the same. Okay, but for delta connection, okay, if they give the line voltage, you don't have to worry because it will automatically the same. Line voltage and phase voltage is the same. So you just divide the voltage, okay, the voltage given, just divide by the impedance directly, okay, then you get the current. But the current give you get is the phase current, not the line current, okay. The phase current is like this, get the phase current like this. And for the line current, you have to use this one, okay. You have to use this one. IR is this one. IR is equal to IRY minus IBR. The trick is, it start with R and end with R, following the sequence. Okay. If for example IA means that you have to IAB minus ICA. Okay. Don't forget it is minus. Okay. Make sure that this is the start with this and end with R. Okay. Start with A. Okay. A end with A. As I show before here. Yeah? Okay. This one. Okay. See. You have to make sure that this is followed. Then you get the line current. Now we discuss one of the final question. Okay. As I mentioned before, the advantage of three phase compared to the single phase is quite popular, so you have to know the advantages. Okay, in slide there are only one, so for this one you have to take from here. Okay, this one is from slide, this one also from slide, this one there is no from slide, this one also not from slide. Okay, this one, if not mistaken, is available in slide. So you have to remember this because this is quite a popular question for three-phase theory. Okay, star delta. So this one, you have to remember the relationship, which is this one and this one, the general formula. This one is only apply for the balance load. So this one is an example of star-star connection. Star-star connection means that the generation is star, the load is also star connected. Okay, delta-star connection means that the generator is delta and the load is star. So you have to know that this is generator, this is represent the load. Okay. So positive, okay. Positive sequence mean RYB or ABC. Which one you use is okay. Okay, this one is balance load, means that the current will be the same. The magnitude of the current will be the same, but the phase is different. So because of that, calculate all the phase current to the side of the load. So in the star connection, the phase and line current are the same. So RY is 10, 0, so given here. RY is, of course, negative 120 degree because you have to minus 120 degree, and IB is positive 120 or negative 240 degree. So because they give it, you have to follow it. Yeah? Okay, yes, you can see here is A, no ARMS, right? Just assume this is in RMS, in phasor. Either all the value here is given in RMS. Okay. The next question is find the voltage at the load side. Okay. At the load side means that you have to find the phase voltage. Okay. Okay. Phase voltage is just use using Ohm's law, IRZR. So don't forget to put your calculator in complex mode, because this is a complex calculation. Okay, the same with IY. Okay, also use the same one, and IB also use the same method. Just use the Ohm's law. As you can see here, the magnitude will be the same. If your calculation is correct, the magnitude will be the same, and the phase will be 120 degree apart from each other. Okay, for line voltage, you can use a formula. Okay, either you can use a Kirchhoff voltage law, or you can use the formula, which is square root of 3. Okay, V phase. This one is the V phase. Only the magnitude you taken. Okay, for RY. Okay, for RY means that you have to find to use the R, the angle of R. Okay. Remember this given to you. Okay. Okay, this one. Okay. VAB means that you have to take the angle of A. Okay, this one is A. You have to take the angle of A and plus 30. Okay, VRY, negative square root 3, 500. So the voltage is, okay, as you can see here, is 36.86. So 36.86 plus 30. Make sure you add bracket here, because this is can be different with answer. So you have to put a bracket. Okay, this is the answer. Same with here, VYB. So you have to put square root 3 multiplied by 100, or you just copy this. And the angle is, you copy the angle here. Okay, the angle Y. Okay, VY, because VYB, right? You have to look at the Y. Okay, you can see here. The Y, VY is, or VYN, either way is correct, is negative 83.14. Negative 3, where is it? Negative 83.14 plus 30. Okay. Same here. Yeah. You do the same. So, that's it. For the 1, 2, 3, 4. Fourth question is the power, which is discussed in the next part of this chapter. And also, at the, also the next part of the chapter. Okay, I give you another example of final question. Okay, as you can see here. Okay. Advantages of three phase compared to the single phase. This is quite popular question. So you can see here. The answer, okay, you just memorize it. And for question B, you have to draw and label. Okay, this one try to refer to the previous video, and I show you how to draw and label correctly the system. Okay, a three phase Y connected load. Okay, to a balanced three phase delta connected voltage source, means that star delta connection. Okay, you can see here, you have to do it correctly. No, don't forget to label the current here. Current goes positive, goes from IRY. IRY means that IY to R. Okay, don't forget here also. Here. Now for C, a three phase Y connection load, okay, which has impedance of 40 plus j 25. Okay, phase impedance means that for each phase there are 40 plus j 25. Okay, is supplied by a balanced positive sequence delta source. Okay, and VRY is 210, means that this one will be the reference. The reference means that the angle is zero. Okay, now you have to calculate the load phase voltage. This is the line voltage. Okay, so how to do this? you have to change the line voltage to phase voltage using the formula. Okay, but be careful because this is from line to phase. Okay, before this is phase to line. The formula given is phase to line. Now line to phase means that VAN is VAB. Okay, make sure that A and A. Okay, divide by square root 2 and minus 30 degree. Okay, because in A or RY is basically 0 degree because of the positive sequence. Okay, the reference as a reference. So 0 minus 30 means that this one. This is the VAN. Okay, for the second question, after you get the phase voltage, you have to know the phase current. And for delta connection, okay, see this Y connection or star connection, okay, the line current and the phase current is the same. So means that IR is or IA is VAN divided by ZY. Okay, just divide because you already find the phase voltage, you just use the ohm's law. Then you get the line current. So you, because the question only asks only one, okay, first I only ask one voltage. So for this one, you don't have to calculate one by one. Means that IA equal to VAN divided by ZY, IB equal to VBN divided by ZY, and IC IC equals to VCN divided by ZY. Okay, if they you already calculate it, it's okay. But if they don't, only you have to calculate only one, just minus it. Okay, you can see that you can just minus 120 degree from this value, because remember the balance load, the current always 120 degree apart. So minus, and then this one also minus. Make sure that, or you can add it. Okay, this one added by 120 degree. As mentioned before, it is important for you to know how to draw the phasor diagram for each component. For this case, you have to draw the phasor, phase current and phase current of the source and phase current of the load. Okay, if you look at here, you already calculate this one R, IR, RY, IB. Now you have to calculate the current here. It's basically you just use a formula. Okay, you have to find the value. Okay, for this case they don't calculate it, but because the mark is quite high, you have to calculate using the formula. Okay, this is the formula. You have to use delta because the current is, okay, if you look here, the source side is the delta connection. So you have to use this formula. Okay, line current change to phase current. Okay, instead of minus you get plus. Okay, you can see the answer here. Okay, IA here, IB, okay, unfortunately the answer is incorrect. So try to do this. Okay, you have to correct it because VRN is at zero. This one is incorrect. And the last question is power, which is discussed in the next lecture. Okay, thank you.